Hello, I'm Jackson Lamy. It's a pleasure to meet you. Or have you meet me? Well, hopefully it's a pleasure for you to meet me. But I'd love to meet you. Probably. Anyways, thank you so much for checking out my video. I'd be much obliged to introduce you to my project, The Adoration of the Magi, as well as some of my artwork. Let's start off by showing you some art that's available on skyoptional.com. About me, I was raised in Canandaigua, which is near Rochester, in the upstate region of New York. I grew up skateboarding, snowboarding, playing golf. I've always loved art and actually had the idea for this project while I was still in high school. I got into art more seriously when I was about 17, which is when I first had the idea for the project I'll be speaking about. I love to read books. I also like to write and talk. I definitely have social media, including Facebook and Instagram.
You know, I couldn't help but notice that I've been getting any likes or comments from Facebook.
Well, that's because I barely go on Facebook.
Okay.
What are you on about?
I'm trying to make some progress on that. All right. Have a great day.
I've also been making some progress on my chess skills recently.
You want to play some chess?
Come on, man. Cannot beat me in chess.
I joined the Army in 2018, and I'm still on my first contract, but I recently re-enlisted to go to Baumholder, Germany, where I'll go October of this year.
Let's go, man. During the weekdays, you can usually find me working on trucks, doing details, going to ranges, and field training exercises. Two sergeant, three sergeant, four sergeant.
The project that I'm making this video about is called The Adoration of the Magi. It started as an oil painting, and I'm now turning that painting into a 3D environment. I'm still working on the painting. It has a long and storied history. I began in 2004 doing some sketches and finished my first version in 2007. I always planned on finishing the picture, or more accurately, making a better version, but I was just waiting for the right time. I tried to enlarge it to 17 feet and do it in 6 sections back in 2010, but this is as far as I got. So this is 1/6 of the total composition, and I even made larger scale models of the figures individually painted on 8-inch by 11-inch sheets to complement or complete this version of the piece. The trick was to get the picture as large and majestic as I possibly could, but this concept didn't work out because this single sheet glued onto the board experienced warping, and I didn't feel confident to pursue the completion in this format, although there were some interesting developments along the way. Painting is on about 100 sheets of cardstock paper on magnetic adhesive sheets. The board is coated in magnetic primer so the sheets stick to it. Magnetic primer is basically oil primer with iron flakes in it. It's very heavy, and the board is very heavy. So the whole painting is very, very heavy, upwards of 200 to 250 pounds.
I give up.
I've moved around quite a bit, and instead of moving a giant painting, I just have to stack up all the pieces into a small box, and I get a new board wherever I end up. I've even worked on it in smaller parts, and even sold prints of smaller pieces of the painting. As you see here, the picture is now glued permanently onto the board, which makes it a lot harder to transport the painting, but also a lot easier to work on. I'm going to Germany in October. Wonder how I'm going to get this huge painting overseas.
Yeah, maybe we should put on something with wheels. It's a good idea, Sam, right?
Oh boy, get on the bike. Get on the bike,
guy. Hey! Walk on the ocean.
A little bit about the Adoration of the Magi. You may have heard of it before, but not quite know what it's all about. In the Renaissance, the Adoration of the Magi was a common theme in artwork. It was painted by Giotto, Botticelli, Leonardo da Vinci, among many others. It was usually a church commission. The Adoration is a Catholic theme, hence it being popular in Italy. The Magi were the three kings who visited Jesus when he was born and gave him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. I was very inspired by Da Vinci's unfinished Adoration. The use of the perspective and the implied lines helped to motivate my own painting. As you see, the image depicts a building in several foreground and background levels. The style of the building has a strong nod to neoclassicism with elements of fantasy and surrealism. It's designed to be very different and to be attractive. I drew a lot of inspiration from these guild halls in Brussels. From the School of Athens painting, and from the Sistine Chapel. I wanted to entertain. I deviate from historical architecture and that I want to raise the bar from conformity to adventure, achievement, entertainment, and competitiveness. The ribbons are an integral part of the painting and are in the initial stages. They interact with the background and influence the colors and the surroundings. They are full of life, a current of electricity that flows through the painting which conducts them. They are born out of the building and coalesce in the center of the symmetrical design. They unite the composition with broad sweeping arcs and add chaos and uncertainty, interfering wherever they can in the building scenery. The 3D model is a recreation of the painting and is being modeled using Autodesk Maya, a professional animation software used for feature animation films. In real life, it would be over 2 miles long and 2,000 feet tall. These arches that you see here are over 1,500 feet high and over a quarter mile wide. The 3D environment is designed to be a fully designed place inside and out. Like a video game, you can explore the area and also watch visual effects like fireworks, the seasons changing, storms, rolling fog, passing clouds, things that spark your own imagination and enjoyment of life. The rooms will have themes and be based off specially designed artworks using holograms, custom-built furnishings with mechanical, modifiable architecture. This place will be loaded down with digital artwork, sculpture, indoor streams, waterfalls, fountains, and laser light shows. Transparent glass floors and walls housing miniature cities, forests, farmlands, aquariums, and exotic animals which live in their own habitat that's intertwined with the building. I want users to explore in virtual reality, even view a 3D printed model as well. The place can be used by game design studios or animated films, and its concept is unique, the most thoroughly designed animated model in existence, complete with VFX, characters, and storylines that constitute a truly epic poem. Movies can use the place for scenes, and video games can use the place as a setting for their own adventures. I love great artwork, and I consume it rapidly on social media. I want to buy it and sell it, promote it, collect it. Architectural ideas, I want to use them. Fine art, I want it in the project, like a giant museum. I see so many extraordinary sculptures and glasswork, digital paintings and animation, and traditional artwork. I want to bring everything together. I collect thousands of inspiring images and content on Facebook and Instagram and DeviantArt. I want to take it a step further and incorporate them into the project itself, which would involve agreements with many different artists, even money to pay them, for assurances they will get recognition and publicity. There's going to be a massive engine in the center of the place. All this complex machinery is attractive to the eye. The complex movements of clocks, quantum computers, particle accelerators, electron microscopes, and laser physics laboratories. The marriage of technology and art, and the sounds of moving parts, machined elements fitting into place, the friction of metal, the sliding of lubricated machined pieces, bearings, spring-loaded mechanisms, much like cocking and loading of guns. art that brings together these satisfying audible and aesthetic elements into large-scale works or small-scale puzzles and displays, engineered to provoke thought, combine provocative technology, and provide an immersive experience. The file is too heavy to add lots of realistic grass, water, and effects, so I've broken it up into 12 different subfiles where I'm adding more realistic foliage and some of the finer accessories available for the program that I use, Autodesk Maya. It's amazing how time flies, but at each point in time we can marvel at the world, at our loved ones, at our accomplishments, the love of the chase. We can see our options clearly and take our chances. The rain and the clear blue skies are both part of everyone's life, and as we move forward, the path is pleasant and also challenging. I work on this picture in cycles. It's usually something like painting for a month, the website and marketing for a few weeks, a digital model for a month, plus other paintings. Plus, I'm going to school part-time and working full-time. Some people ask themselves, do I live to work or do I work to live? For me, my most rewarding experiences are in working on my projects, and what I consider true happiness is the inspiration to get down to business and get things done. I feel like the next level is just within my grasp. I just need to better myself and be more efficient and smarter at what I do. I buy models to put into the building, like trees and statues. It'd be impossible to model everything myself in this big of a scene, so I purchase them through many different websites. Visit my Patreon account, which is linked below, and you can contribute as much or as little as you want monthly to help me keep the wheels in motion, and cancel whenever you want. I also have a GoFundMe account and a Cash App address and paintings for sale. I'd love to meet with you if you like my work. Give me a call or text. Send me an email. I'm just a stone's throw away.
Okay.
Please send this website and video to friends and relatives.
Okay.
Who do you know with an interest in art and animation? I want everyone in this country to know about the project before I sell this painting. Like, share, subscribe, comment on the YouTube video as well. Look, I know I'm asking a lot, but in reality, I'm happy if you enjoy the project, if you like my work, in the video. Thanks for watching. I wish you many joyful years of bountiful health and prosperity ahead. My phone is always on, and my email is always ready to get emails. Yours truly, Jackson Lamy from skyoptional.com.
What a dream.
Thank you.
Yeah.